Welcome to the Coffee Journeys show, hosted by me, Piotr Zagorowski, author of the Coffee Journeys blog. In this show, I'll be sharing my journey from being a technical person to a leader and discussing topics such as leadership, technology, and intentional living. I'll be sharing my unique perspective and insights and offering guidance on how to develop the skills and mindset needed to succeed in today's world. Whether you're an aspiring leader, a technology enthusiast, or simply looking to learn more about the world around you, this podcast is for you. So, join me for the engaging and thought-provoking conversations on leadership, technology, and intentional living on the Coffee Journeys Show. Welcome back to yet another episode of my podcast, where we explore leadership, growth, and occasionally we deep dive into life over a cup of coffee, of course. And today I want to talk about something fundamental that so many leaders overlook. It's not about goals, KPIs, or how to get ahead, but about time. We will be talking about a real deadline. When I record this episode, it's November, and it's traditionally time to think about more serious topics. And this episode will also serve as an opportunity to slow down, reflect, and ultimately live more intentionally. So grab your coffee, sit back, and let's chat. We live in a world where there is always something to do. The Industrial Revolution promised to improve the quality of life for many, and while it actually brought some innovations, it also brought the system of hierarchical management, crazy working hours, and eventually the 9-to-5 grind. Fast forward to the digital revolution, and automation came along, and suddenly there was the promise of making work easier, freeing up time and reducing the monotony of our tasks. But did we take this extra time to relax? No. No, we actually filled it more and more with work, more tasks, more goals, and more everything to do. And as leaders, we are all too familiar with this stuff. The 21st century has brought instant gratification to every aspect of our lives. Let's talk about communication. Now every email demands instant responses. How about our goods? We have next day delivery in our home, and this is now a norm. We always choose to do it. And if something, we need to wait something for something a week, is already too long. Let's take a look in entertainment. If it's not available on demand, we lose patience and we switch to another streaming platform. This kind of now mindset can trickle into our leadership styles too. We project manage our lives, we add deadlines, and try to get everything done without pausing to reflect. But here's the thing. We only have one real deadline, and this is not work related. So let's pause for a moment and take a look. As leaders, we are expected to keep doing, keep going, set examples, and always push forward. But sometimes, living intentionally means going in the opposite direction, reflecting on what truly matters, something we don't often do in our fast-paced lives. So let's take a step back and ask ourselves, what is our real deadline? This is another topic that is quite heavy, but bear with me and I will give you exercise to go through. It's called a calendar of life. Let's put things into perspective. Imagine this. Your lifespan is a week. And let's take an average lifespan of 84 years. We can do 100 years or whatever. I choose 84 because it's good for this calculation. So it looks like this. 0 to 12 years old is Monday. 13 to 24 years old is Tuesday. 25 to 36 is Wednesday. 37 to 48 is Thursday. 49 to 60 is Friday. 61, 72 is Saturday, and finally 73 to 84, it's Sunday. So we're taking our expected average lifespan and assume it's 84. We then put it into a week view to our simplified life calendar. And now let's try to fill in with our life highlights of this time frame. Could be high school, could be university, could be marriage, kids, jobs, everything that's worth putting in. Maybe you can add some points for the future achievements if you like, if you plan, if you already have planned for next decade, let's say. Now, let's pause and contemplate. How do you feel? I'm, for instance, in my mid-40s or late-40s, so sometimes it's already Thursday for these folks, sometimes already early Friday, and I still got time, but it's the week is mostly gone. And if you're listening and sipping your coffee, think about where you are in this calendar, how many days you have left. This simple exercise helps you put our deadline into perspective, doesn't it? To check on full exercise, you can go to coffeejourneys.blog/deadline. But let's carry on because there is more. So, how do you use this understanding to lead more intentionally and to live your life more intentionally? How do we stop getting caught up in this noise? One of my favorite frameworks is from Derek Sivers. And it's called Hell Yes or No. If you're not familiar with it, it's a simple rule that can change the way you look at decisions. And decisions especially that lead to more work that you need to do and more stuff on your life. Here's how it works. If you are not saying hell yeah about something, you just simply say no. If it's just yes, it equals no. It has to be 110% hell yeah to choose something. It's simple, right? But it's powerful, especially when you are leading. As a leader, you're constantly bombarded with projects, opportunities, meetings. But if you are not excited about this, if it doesn't make sense, if you don't align with it, with vision and your goals, it's probably better to say no. This approach leaves room for the thing that truly matters. Things that make you say hell yeah. And let me tell you, sipping a coffee and reflecting on this is the perfect way to figure out what those things are. Let's go a little bit deeper. This isn't just about saying no to things, it's about understanding your why. And one philosophy that helps me with this is Stoicism. And now, don't worry, I'm not getting to dive into full philosophy lecture or anything, but there is one key Stoic principle that I want to share with you. And that one principle is Memento Mori, which means remember you will die. And I know, it sounds heavy, but it's also freeing. And reminds us that our time is finite, and that should guide us into making better decisions about where we invest our energy. The Stoics taught us to value time over possessions, to reflect on what really matters, and to live with intention. If you're a leader or aspiring to be one, this mindset is gold. And by the way, Marcus Aurelius and Seneca would have probably loved a good cup of coffee while pondering these big questions. So I will leave you with this. As you sip your next cup of coffee, take a moment to reflect on your real deadlines, your goals, and whether the things you're spending time on making you say hell yes. Leaders aren't just defined by how much they accomplish, but by how well they manage their time, energy, and focus. And remember, your time is one currency that can't be earned back. So how will you spend it? Thanks for tuning in to this episode. I must say it was heavy, but I hope it will help you to find out what you are really optimizing for. Until next time, keep sipping, keep reflecting, and keep leading intentionally. And this is all I have for you today. I value feedback a lot. That's why I ask you to review my podcast in your favorite podcasting platform and give it as many stars as you think it deserves. By doing so, this podcast is going to be more visible and I can reach more people to provide value. And before you go, if you would like to join the community of people who are determined to help each other and grow together, join my newsletter at coffeejourneys.blog/newsletter. Thanks for tuning in today, and until next time, have a great day.